In this wonderful show, Durarara. I'd like to kind of play the opening, you know, so you guys just wrap you up with the song. But as soon as they fix it, we will play it.
Woo.
Yes.
And then I'll also show a clip later on from the show. Exactly. I voiced that guy. And what this panel is about, it's, first of all, let me find out who has seen Durarara.
Wow. That's kind of what we're here.
I would hope so.
Who's also seen Durarara times two?
Yes, almost.
Who has not seen Durarara?
Get on that.
What's your name?
Steven.
Okay. Well, that's what this panel is about, basically. It's to try and convince those, and also you can express your love of Durarara. And this is the kind of cool thing. I do have prizes, if you don't know that.
Ooh.
There's some prizes.
Yo, rad.
So Steven, right?
Yes.
Okay, come up here, Steven. Come on up here. Woo! Okay. So, Steven has not seen the show. Okay, so I want to find out from you, why have you not seen the show?
I just recently graduated from college, so I was really busy with work and everything.
Uh-huh.
And now since I have free time, I can watch it now.
Okay, so he has some free time, maybe he'll be able, but he's never seen the show.
Okay, see?
We're taking the long walk. Okay, see that door? Get out of here! No, okay, come on, Steven. I'm not gonna kick you out. Not yet. Not yet. I'm not gonna kick you out yet. Okay, so now that you have time, we're going to convince Steven, and if anybody else walks in that has not seen the show, we're going to convince them to watch it. Let me ask you guys. You know what? First of all, I do need some helpers.
Sure.
Anybody? Now, usually what I do, I kind of pick someone who's cosplaying Durarara.
Don't worry. Oh.
Well, I mean,
so if you're cosplaying, come up.
Yes.
Awesome. Great. You want to explain your character real quick?
Yeah, okay, so I'm a douchebag. Isaiah is known as the flea. He's an informant and he loves humans in a very, very twisted way. In that Isaiah loves their reactions, and so he likes to poke and prod at them. And if Isaiah were to play Dungeons and Dragons, he would be done chaotic, neutral, hardcore. That's all you have to know about this movie bag. And he's a man. I'm just gender bending.
You two can do
sure one on.
Yeah. So we have two Shizuos. So, okay, 1, 2, 3, go. Talk about your character.
First of all, I
at the same time.
Go.
Oh,
God.
Hate that son of a bitch.
Yeah.
He pisses me off.
Lack of patience, super strength, heavy smoker.
I just don't like him.
Okay.
He denies that he's in love with me, but he is.
If I see him on the street, I'll smear him on the pavement.
Oh. You have to catch
there you
me
go.
First, darling.
Now, Shinra?
Shinra? Who's actually a dude, but I'm gender bending.
I love the gender bending Shinra.
Hey!
Isn't that cool? I've never had a gender bending Shinra in my panel before.
We convinced him.
It's awesome.
We're the trio, yeah.
He has a very nice butt, so it works.
Tell me about your character.
Well, Shinra is a scientist.
You know what my favorite part is? Blow up louder. Okay, here we go. You guys ready?
Let's sit down.
Louder.
eye of the dark.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, let me see if, let's show a scene maybe for while we have the light. Let me just see if I can get out of this.
But I don't really trust
terrible
these
with these things.
Okay.
Anyway, let's see.
I don't think anyone.
Okay, you guys want to see a scene?
Sure.
Yeah.
More about it? Okay. Let's see. Yeah, you want to dim the lights a little bit? Oh, okay, no, that's fine.
Yeah.
Okay, let's
show.
Okay.
Oh.
The green is the enlarge.
Okay. So I get all confused when I do. Because we're going to, let's show it. So this, if you have not seen the show, Steven, this kind of gives you
good
a little background sort of, well, not background, but this kind of shows you a lot of Izai and Shizuo and even how Mikado reacts to things. So here we go. And if this will explain absolutely nothing about the show.
Woo!
So just enjoy.
Yeah!
That was like a convenience store trash can that came flying at us. But why? Holy shit.
Well, what's up, Isaiah?
Bartender?
Didn't I tell you I was the foot of Ike Ukuro again? You remember that, Isaiah, don't ya?
Shizu-chan. Last I heard, you had some gig working over by the West Coast.
Got fired ages ago. And I'm pretty sure that I've told you never to call me that. My name's Shizuo Hewajima. Try to get it right.
Shizuo Hewajima? That's the other guy I'm asking you not to piss off.
Oh, come on, Shizu-chan. So I pinned you for something you didn't do. Who needs to get so mad?
Oh, I'm not mad. I just want to beat the shit out of you.
You know, the problem with you, Shizu-chan, is that you can't be swayed by reason.
Yeah.
That's bad. Really bad. Now let me go.
That's a guy!
Oh, yeah.
Just to make a fool out of me.
I love that guy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you remember the other scene?
Right.
Yes.
Okay, I was going to wait until we start talking about it with Isaiah, but let me just tell you something funny. I was at another con, and I kind of do, a lot of times I'll say, okay, what do you think Isaiah is my question. And, who wants to explain the scene I'm thinking of? You know what I'm talking about, where his head gets shaved?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I asked him, I said, well, what do you think, and the guy had never seen the show, but he saw that clip. And I said, what do you think Isaiah is? And he said, a barber. Anyway, that has nothing to do with this, but here we go.
Go play it around with the dollars.
Right. What's with the bartender?
I don't know. He wasn't here a minute ago.
Who's that? Shizuo Hewajima?
What the hell do you want? In the face of fear, your average man will lose his ability to think rationally.
God bless that guy.
That's not gonna end well.
It didn't.
Don't lift for my head. You have to know a blow like that could kill a guy, right? And this means that you were intentionally trying to kill me, right? So then, whatever happens next is what you deserve, right? Men with overwhelming power instinctively strike fear into the hearts of others. He's violence personified. It's what he lives and breathes. Simply put, he's the very definition of violence.
Oh.
Where did he come from?
Anyway, that's the bewildered mikado again. Okay, so where were we? Come on up, guys. Come on,
everyone. Right.
Shinra, who are you?
So we didn't get Shinra to explain.
So Shinra is a scientist who is in love with Salty, who is a Dullahan. Or the Black Rider.
Was it the Black Rider?
Yeah.
It's been like a year.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. But yeah, he's in love with Salty, and he's a scientist at heart, so he likes dissecting people.
And I'll just add one more thing. I don't think it's really stressed enough in Durarara, but Shinra is sick, sick, sick.
Oh yeah.
I mean, seriously, he's a great guy, but think about what his dad made him do when he was a kid. Okay, I'm just saying, it's just never explained, but anyway. But I love Shinra. I need you guys up here. Oh my gosh. I just need one helper. Okay, well, you guys have seen the Hunger Games, right? So I just need one of you. Three of you will not make it. So you are going to compete in the ultimate deadly game of rock, paper, scissors.
Oh no!
And only one will survive.
My worst.
Yes. Okay, I guess we're gonna start with the two Shizuos.
There can only be one, right?
So can there only be one?
Are we
going on shoot or three?
Shoot.
Okay. That's one down. Nope, come over here.
If I stab him, do I win?
Well, you might end up in jail.
Such a kidder.
Yeah, I love you.
But see, there's no knife in rock, paper, scissors. Okay.
There are scissors.
There are scissors, though.
Well, this is really sad, though, because aren't they good friends?
Awkwardly, yeah.
It is debatable. So, we'll see who survives.
Oh!
You know, I'll tell you this. Shizuos usually always win. Yeah. When I do this, honestly, I don't know what it is.
Instinct.
But they usually always win.
Threat of violence.
Right. Thank you.
Good fight.
Yes. Okay, so this is what I need you to do.
No, you stay.
You won.
You won. You're stuck now. Okay, so this is very easy. Very easy. Now, this is how, you know, like I said, I have a lot of down there.
Stash.
Yes. And then how you win is if you participate in some kind of way or answer a question or whatever, everyone gets at least just one ticket, okay? And but of course you can participate as much as you want, but one ticket per person. So you get one first since you're my helper. If I can get it done right.
Take
your time.
Yeah. Well, that's why I have you. I need someone with strength to tear these. You take one, and let's see, give the ticket, you keep the ticket, put it in your pocket, and then you keep this coupon, put it in here, and we'll do a raffle at the very end. You'd be surprised at how many people actually mess it up. I had one person one time, like, give everybody the full ticket.
That's what you got for getting Shizuo.
And I was like, oh, I can't, how can I do a raffle? Everyone has their...
Wait.
Oh, no, you gotta wait, yeah, they don't get it yet. Not yet.
This is what you get.
Not yet. Wah, wah, wah. Okay. Yeah, so, yeah, that's okay. You'll see. And you hold on to the back.
You gotta do all the heavy lifting.
This is a lot of instruction for someone like this. I don't know if you can do this.
You can do it. There you go, just start with these.
Can she do it? Yes, she can.
She read the solid baby.
Woo!
No, not yet.
Sorry.
That's okay, you're doing well. You know, strength, but you know.
Not much yet.
Excuse me?
Shizuo doesn't always have a lot of brains.
No,
but,
excuse
know,
me.
You'll be fine. Okay, there you go. So that one goes in there. This one's yours, right? Yeah. Okay, keep that. Put it in your pockets. You don't.
You know, I'm kind of dressed up just like you, except for I have the tie.
There you go.
Okay. Pocket shoes. And then just hang on those, and then whoever's fabric. Next. There's a hole in it.
Yeah, but as soon as they answer a question or something, so it's one, they have to participate. Yeah.
Woo!
All right. So, let me ask you guys, God bless you. You don't get a ticket for sneezing. Or coughing. I was going to ask you guys, if you were going to explain to Steven why he should watch Durarara, or if you were an alien come from outer space, I don't care what, and you needed to explain what the show is about, what would you tell them, what would you tell them it's about?
Teenage Street Gang, Anita Bukuro.
Okay, he gets a ticket.
Ooh.
Was it you? No? Yeah? Yeah. And tell me your name. Stand up so everybody can hear it.
She has more time speaking.
You'll be fine. You're
you can do it! Woo! Woo!
Jory Crane. That's her name.
Okay. You can tell me in my ear and I'll tell them.
Oh.
What do you think Durarara is about? She said it's about Sailor Moon? Pokemon Go?
Catch
she him. Said it's about Shizuo. Izaya always pissing Shizuo off. That's part of it.
That's like a good 30%, yeah.
I think it's about the intersection of different societies in the world. You've got heavy emphasis on a criminal element. You've also got a lot of high school kids. And you've also got a fantastic element. You have Selfie, you have Henri with the swords and stuff like that.
Spoiler.
Three different elements, four different elements, intersecting.
Yeah, I love that whole fantastic supernatural section to it.
I'm so good at this. Oh.
I can summarize.
No, you've got to keep one in the back. Yeah, we broke it in the back. No, you have to keep one in the back. Let's go down here. What did you do?
Yeah! So I think it's a coming-of-age story for young children as they're trying to find who they are in the world and how they affect other people and other groups.
I've met you two before, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you won a prize for me before, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I came with my sister.
Oh, awesome. I remember you guys. Okay, way in the back, and I'll come back to you guys. Way in the back.
I said the slice of life about the semi-paranormal.
Very good.
Pretty good.
I'd like to make them run.
Good.
Yeah.
In a single sentence, everybody has secrets. And it's an exploration of the human psyche and looking at how secrets affect people and how you can put on a front, but then there's like a true nature underneath.
Exactly. You guys won the video game, right? Val, did you win that?
It was the movie.
The movie, that's right, okay.
Do I have to give you one?
Yeah, you gotta give her one. Okay, this Shizuo.
Your counterpart. The other one, Shizuo part two.
Shizuo
with times two, sorry about that.
Okay.
Yes.
I would say that it's about finding your place in the world, well, in the big city of Tokyo, for better or worse. Whether that be with crime, whether that be on the streets, or whether that be having some sort of weird, magical, supernatural element to it.
Very good. Anybody else? Okay. Right here?
I guess I would plainly say it's a 21st century take on the Boris Game version of the Headless Horseman.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's a good
or have you ever seen Pulp Fiction?
Yes.
It's a clash between gangs with a supernatural side element.
Awesome.
to you. And
thanks.
Let's do trap right here.
Wonderful.
I think it's also kind of like,
at his cost
a lot of people are saying, like the human psyche and all, and how people like connect with each other, but they also hide things. And just also like growing up, like you'll meet all these different people, and in a way you always connect with people, and it goes back and you meet people again, but you don't even know it.
Very good.
I think they're all just crying out. Can't you just love me as I am?
What? I love everyone.
I think in anime is about like, it like has this game war between by color, but also as a community and you interact, but you also have a supernatural movie, but also based on Dengeki Bunko novel by ATI Media. I am the California smart little talk.
Awesome. This gentleman here in the glasses.
I think it's basically a crime drama with supernatural elements written by a psychologist. So it's basically like Batman.
Oh, yeah.
I'm Batman.
I'm Batman.
It's an impersonal relationship story basically demonstrating careful what you wish for.
Oh. Yes. And you've seen the show. Okay. That is kind of interesting. I guess Henri could be voiced by Molly Ringwald. let me ask you guys, we'll see. Steven.
Yes.
You gotta watch it now, right?
Yeah.
Peer pressured you enough.
But not only that, one of my favorite directors also worked on it, Alex von David.
We met him. He's wonderful.
Well, he did the second season.
Yeah.
But it was Christy Reed did the first season. The second season was kind of weird because it started out with Kirk Thornton, and then I think he did the first four episodes directed, and then he got another job or something. I don't know. He couldn't do it anymore. Then Patrick Sykes did it for a while. And then Alex von David did the ending of it. So we had basically three directors on that show for the second season.
Patrick Sykes, he's a good actor too.
Oh, Patrick. And you know who Patrick voices?
Oh.
You know who Patrick voices in this?
The...
Simon, isn't it?
Yes, Simon.
The sketchiest place in the whole town.
Exactly. Now, you guys know there is a real Ikebukuro.
We were there!
Were you there?
Yeah.
Now, is this true? I heard there are tours you can take. Did you know about this?
No, we were only there for like a night. But we saw the Starbucks.
What about the Kentucky Fried Chicken?
No, but we got Krispy Kremes.
Oh, okay. What about, they have that Sunshine Park?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. We went to Sunshine City.
Isn't that cool? You can actually go there and, like, feel like you're walking around and,
we
you got to be careful where you're walking.
We did.
Yeah, I wouldn't go in an alleyway.
I was in Ikebukuro.
Huh?
I was bummed. I didn't see the Black Rider.
Huge and all what the Robber Rob was.
Now, did you guys see that vending machine? They have a vending, I think it's on my Facebook and maybe Twitter. So you can follow me on Twitter and also Facebook.
Shameless plug, yeah.
But there's a vending machine that has Walker, Erica.
I've seen pictures of it, but we didn't see it.
Have you guys heard of that?
Yeah.
There's a real vending machine in Japan. I don't know if it's in, I think it's in Ikebukuro.
It's that or Shibuya.
Oh, okay.
It's one of the two.
But it's a big vending machine that's got all these Durarara characters on it. Cool. But no mikado.
Oh, sure. It's
the most important character.
But anyway, if you can find it on my Facebook or Twitter. I can't remember which one. It's on there somewhere. Let me ask you guys, who's your favorite character and why?
Shinra.
Why?
Because he just...
Shinra.
I actually cosplayed Shinra. I just didn't have time to change the one panel.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I know. I'm so
many. No, because... At first, I just kind of liked him because he just seemed kind of demented, but then his relationship with Celsie just evolved into this beautiful thing, and I
they're like my OTP of like all animes ever now. And I feel like Shinra is the kind of person who has a darker past, but somehow maintained a pure soul.
Interesting.
Like, even though he's kind of demented mentally, it's more because of what he went through, but I feel like he's still pure in himself.
I think you're twisted, just like she gets a ticket. Yeah.
Yeah.
And Simon is
very rational.
And he's just like more of a spectator
than
ever.
Coming
in and
doing things personally,
I'm like, I kinda like that.
Yeah, that's cool. I like that.
I like you, Diet.
Yes!
Diet?
I had this little I was at a Durarara and I had this little cute, sweet little girl. And I go, who's your favorite character? She goes, her mom sitting next to her. Isaiah, because he does all these bad things. I was like, this is your daughter. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, okay. Isaiah is my favorite, but I have a degree in psychology, and I absolutely adore his take on humanity. And like, what got me into the series was that first episode when he's talking about suicide. Like, that's dark and twisted, but you watch it and you're like, oh, yeah. And I don't know, like, he's so broken, but you never really see that. You don't get it.
He doesn't let on.
No.
We're gonna come back to Isaiah later, but we're gonna get some more favorites. Oh, it's one ticket per person.
One per person.
Yeah.
So, for me, it's a tie between Shizuo, Shinra, and Celty. Celty, I love everything about her aesthetic. I love her personality. I love her background. I love Shinra, like Rebel mentioned, that he's a very compassionate person.
Yeah.
Just not healthy at all. Which
look,
is
his dad. His dad wears a gas mask.
Yeah.
He doesn't even know what his dad looks like.
Oh, God. And then, I'm dressed as the guy.
Yeah.
So Shizuo was a nice guy, though. He needs to calm down.
What other Mikado characters, Mikado, that you think is your favorite Mikado that, you know, I don't want to, like, Mikado pressure anybody.
No name drops.
You want to have a Mikado favorite character that's like Mikado, your favorite best character ever? Okay, you're in battle. Oh!
Did she get like 5 tickets?
Brownie points.
And she thought of that on her own. Take that, Isaiah's in Shinra.
Yeah, he's definitely my favorite because I always found him so relatable. Like, you like get thrown in these crazy situations and you're just like, you don't know how to act. Like, that's me. Like, I'm just like, I don't know really what to do, but you keep your composure kind of.
But he's insane.
But also, like that, like, yeah, he's insane. Like, that's what I was gonna say. Like, and there's sometimes people don't know me, and I can be really crazy. People don't know that. So, like,